Hello, this is Mike Farley. We're in Trophy Club tonight. We've got an awesome project to show you. So the first thing is we had a hillside in this backyard. And so with hillsides, those are always fun. But we even had more of a challenge on this one because we had a retaining wall in the back from the golf course. Yeah, the golf course is down there like 10 feet below the retaining wall, which was about 3 to 4 feet below the house. So the challenge is the trees show you what the original grade is, which is way down there. And so this yard was filled up with dirt. Okay, what we call fill dirt. And so the challenge is you can't set a pool in fill dirt. Bottom of the pool is not an original soil, it's gonna settle. And when it settles, it cracks. And that's not a good thing. And so what we had to do on this pool is we had to come in and do terracing to get the pool and the cabana down lower. But we still couldn't get it low enough like we did next door. We had to come in and put piers. And so there's piers underneath this pool, there's piers underneath this cabana, which is different than some other jobs because we don't want the pool to crack. Okay, so we want things to stay together and hold up really well. So that was the first thing. So we've got some primary views looking out, and we wanted to look at something spectacular because we got the golf course back here. But we wanted a little bit of privacy, but we didn't want to block our whole view because, hey, we're on the golf course, right? So we wanted it to look nice and seem inviting, but still give us a little bit of privacy. So the first thing is the spa is you look from the front door through the family room doors and into the back porch is centered on that view. So we got the nice spa spillway, which is raised. Now, when we raise it, the challenge is we're going downhill. And so you'll see on the back side of the spa, we actually have some stools over there, which make a nice bar area on the back of the spa because we're down 42 inches below the top of the spa. So basically 42 inches, hey, that's like a countertop. So this is the elevation I was talking about here on the back of the spa. You can see the spa is only 18 inches on that side, but math, it's 42 on this side because the yard sloped. Pools are pools because water pools. This is a great yard for a stream. Okay, but we adapted, made it work for a pool. So here you can see we're 42 inches, which is excellent for bar stool height. So if we want to kind of hang out here, we weren't so much into it that we built a counter, but it's a nice place that you can sit and talk to the people that are hanging out in the spa as well. Also, you can sit here and watch the TV. So if there's a good game on, which I think the Cowboys, well, that's a preseason game, so who counts that? This still is above the retaining wall, almost a foot. So we still had grade change in the backyard, but we made the math all work. So nice transition from on the porch down to here. Like I said, there was about 5 foot change in elevation through the whole thing. So we've got a great area over at the spa. We wanted a really cool water features that we could see, but again, we didn't want to build a big wall to block the view of the golf course, so we opted for water bowls. And of course, hey, what's the best thing with water bowls? Fire! So we got fire and water bowls on the back here. We used a color that's kind of a blue-gray. It's called an English lead, which ties in perfectly with the agave plants, which are behind them. It blends with all the blue-gray tones that we have in this particular project. Those are concrete bowls. We came in with a lot of glass tile, and we didn't want to bring in a different material as we came up with the columns, and so we kept the glass tile wrapping around the columns. It kind of ties in. But over on the spa, it's just the split-face travertine, the silver to blend with the travertine elements on the pool as well. We didn't want it to get too contemporary looking. Now, we have a really cool rolled edge down on that spa, which we'll go look at later. And I'm going to step in this pool. You're just waiting to see me if I'm going to step forward and just plant myself in there, but I'm not. I'm going to step over. Okay, we survived. But we have some different changes in elevation. So this area is down 6 inches below the porch. So we actually stepped up and had a whole terrace level with the porch covered with the travertine.
So the other thing is we wanted a cabana. Okay, we wanted a place we could have an outdoor kitchen. We wanted a fireplace, but we didn't want to block our views looking out of the golf course. So the thought process is we could go one side of the yard or the other. And we decided to go this way because the house on that side didn't really have a lot of views looking over into the backyard. And so where we put the cabana here, we actually screen off the neighbor when we're sitting in the cabana area from the cars and everything.
So with the cabana, we wanted some bar stools along with an outdoor kitchen. So we've got a counter here that's 42 inches, which works perfect for bar stools. It's set up, if we weren't cooking, we can have bar stools on both sides. We can have bar stools here and watch the TV when it gets installed. Or we can cook here. We've got the egg on one side, got a lot of prep space here and serving space. And then we have the grill on the other side. Underneath, of course, we got trash, we've got a nice fridge. We got an area to store stuff under the egg, so it's a great spot. We've got some space here. We can have a couple of chairs and hang out by the fireplace. And the cool thing is when we hang out and look at the fireplace, we can't even hardly see the neighbor's house at all, much less their driveway and their cars and all that kind of stuff. So it gives us a really nice private feeling. Basically, we can't see their house, but we can see their yard, which is nice, and we can see all their trees, which is even better, and we can see the golf course, which is even more wonderful. So it's a great place to sit here. It's private. We've got the fireplace to enjoy our fall and spring and winter evenings. We've got the awesome pool. We set it up for basketball. You, of course, will see the basketball goal right about here in those sleeves, but we took it out. So the spa is perfect height. It's raised up 18 inches. I can just sit on the edge. I can swing my legs, get around. It's real easy. We came in with the spill edges on the spa, which matches with the spill edges on the water bowl, so we have consistency in the water features going across the back of the pool. We did a rolled tile edge, which is really comfortable. Also looks really pretty with the glass tile and the silver travertine. We like the gray tones on this particular job. So we've got the silver travertine, we got the colored and textured deck, and used the very light gray from a color standpoint. Wanted to keep the furniture kind of out of the main lines of sight, so we set up an area over here. We could have some tables or lounge chairs. We also set another area over on the other side that we could have some lounge chairs. So as we look out, again, we can see the spa and the fire bowls and the water bowls and the golf course. So that's what we want to see 365 days when we look outside the house. So it looks wonderful. Of course, the patio is hideous looking because the builder did that and they didn't want that patio. And so we covered it with the silver travertine. We used a Versailles pattern on the whole thing. It looks great as we transition from there and step down the 6 inches to the pool. On the cabana, we came in again with the gray tones, used the smoke looters. We used a chopped pattern, which was kind of rectangular, not that wild giraffe looking pattern, which kind of ties in with the Versailles pattern of the travertine. Wanted just everything to kind of flow together and fit with the situation. Of course, the house roof and the shingles on the cabana matched each other. The fireplace, again, of the smoke looter stone. So it looks beautiful. We've got a great view of the golf course. We've got a great functional recreational pool, the nice sized tanning ledge, nice average open space, but it fits into this lot. It deals with the grades. We've got a great place here in Trophy Club. So hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you sometime later. Have a great evening.